Hello everyone. Welcome to the Blue Cube channel. This is the fifth lesson of the Illustrator software training course, from beginner to advanced, which I am going to teach you. In this video, you will learn how to work with selection tools and various copy methods for objects. Copying objects may seem simple, but in Adobe Illustrator, there are extensive and important settings related to this topic that we will cover. First, I create two shapes. I'll draw a rectangle and right-click again here and create a circle. In order to create a circle, hold the Shift key on the keyboard and create a circle in this way. Now, I choose a red color for the circle from the fill section. With the selection tool, I select the rectangle and choose a color for it as well. With the selection tool, we can select objects. If I click on each of these objects, I can select them and move them accordingly. I place the mouse at the corner of the shape, and you can see that the mouse cursor changes, allowing me to rotate the shape. Again, if I hold down the Shift key while rotating, the shape rotates in 45-degree increments each time. If I release the Shift key, the rotation becomes free, and by holding down the Shift key and left-clicking, I can rotate the rectangle at a 45-degree angle. Now, if I click and drag on the corners or points on the shape, I can reshape it. If I go to this corner where the mouse cursor changes and hold down the Shift button, you can see that the entire shape becomes smaller or larger in proportion. Now, if I hold down the Alt key and move the mouse again, you can see that the shape becomes smaller or larger from both sides. These are very important tools in the topics we will work on later. All these tools and features will help us. Now, you can hold down the Shift and Alt keys simultaneously. You will see that the shape becomes larger or smaller uniformly on both sides. As a result, by holding down both the Shift and Alt keys, our shape becomes larger or smaller from the center. Okay, I hold down the left click here again and make the shape smaller. As I mentioned in the previous lesson, we can round the corners. Now, I select this circle and place it temporarily on top of this rectangle. I want to make a copy of this circle, but there are different methods for copying. The first method is to select an object like the circle I have selected now and go to the Edit menu and click on Copy. Or instead of coming here and clicking Copy, I can press Ctrl plus C. Both methods perform the same action. So, I click on the Copy button, and then, in the Edit section, I choose the Paste option. You can also press Ctrl plus V, which speeds up the process. When I click Paste, another circle is created in the same shape, and now we can change its color a bit. I select this circle again and press Ctrl plus C, which is the copy shortcut. So instead of going to the Edit menu, I come here and press Ctrl plus C. Again, I go to the Edit section, and this time I click on Paste and Back, which is also the shortcut Ctrl plus B. Here, when I click, the circle should go one step behind compared to the shapes. But we see that this did not happen for the rectangle, and the circle did not go below it. However, if I move this copied shape, you can see that it is now placed below the previous circle but not below the rectangle. In order for the shape we copy to go under the shape we want, we must first select that shape. Let me delete these circles with the Delete key to make things a bit clearer. Now, I select this circle. Press Ctrl plus C here to copy it. I haven't pasted it yet. It's just in the software's memory. To make the circle I copied go below the rectangle, I select the rectangle here, and then I go to the Edit section and click on Paste in Back or press Ctrl plus B. Now when I click, the circle has moved below the rectangle. If I move this circle, you will see that the circle that is now copied for us is placed under this rectangle. So, to make one shape go under another shape, you first need to select the shape, copy it with Ctrl plus C, and then go to the Edit section and choose Paste in Back or press Ctrl plus B. Now, to create a circle that goes above the rectangle, I select it again, press Ctrl plus C to copy the circle, then I select the rectangle, go to the Edit section, and click on Paste in Front. In this way, a new circle is created that is placed on top of the rectangle. I change its color. This way, we can place copies above or below other shapes. I select these shapes and delete them. There is another option called Cut, with the shortcut Ctrl plus X. I select the circle and choose Cut from the Edit menu. This way, the shape is cut, and by pressing Ctrl plus V or Paste, it returns to its original position. I create a new preset or document again from the File menu, then navigate to the new section. Our document is here. I go back to the previous document and make a copy of the rectangle. I press the Ctrl plus C keys and then enter the new document and press Ctrl plus V. In this way, you can see that a rectangle is created in the middle of my document. However, our rectangle was in the previous document at this location. To be able to copy this rectangle exactly in the previous place, I first select the rectangle. Then I press Ctrl plus C. And then I go to the new document and select the Paste in Place option from the Edit menu. The shortcut for this command is Shift plus Ctrl plus V. In this way, the rectangle is placed exactly where it was in the previous document. Again, I select the shapes with the selection tool and press the Delete key. Now this message appears, saying that we can save the document, and I say no. Now, let me go to the File menu and create a new preset with multiple artboards. In this way, a new document is created with multiple artboards. For example, I want it to have 4 artboards. Then, I press the Create button. Now, I have a document with 4 artboards. Later, we will fully discuss the artboard section. But now, I only mentioned it for your familiarity with this topic. Now, I go back to my previous document, click and drag with the selection tool to select these 2 shapes, press Ctrl plus C to copy them. Then, I go to the new document, and from the Edit section, I choose Paste on all artboards. This way, the shapes are copied to all the artboards like this. So, with this method, we can copy one or several objects to multiple artboards. If I press Ctrl plus V here, you can see that the shapes align in the center, which is not useful for us. So, I press Ctrl plus Z to go back and choose Paste on all artboards from the Edit section. This way, the shapes exactly return to their original positions. Now, I'm closing this for now. Please note that in the Edit section, there is an option called Undo Paste, which has now changed, and its shortcut is Ctrl plus Z. See, now if I press Ctrl plus X to cut the circle end, you can see that this option changes to undo cut. So with Ctrl plus Z, I can go back one step. Actually, the name of this option changes with each command, but with Ctrl plus Z you can always go back. Now, if I press Ctrl plus V, the circle returns to its original position. So, from the Edit section, you can go back several steps using Ctrl plus Z. You can see that I went back several steps, and the deleted circles have returned. If I press Ctrl plus Shift plus Z, I can move forward, as you can see here. Shift plus Ctrl plus Z moves forward, and with Ctrl plus Z, it goes backward. Another quick way to copy is to select the selection tool and hold down the left click and the Alt button and drag. make lots of copies very easily. I copy the rectangle by holding the Alt button and dragging. I hit Ctrl plus Z again several times to go back. Thank you for staying with me until the end of this video. Remember, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, click the subscribe button or the subscribe below the video, and please like the video. Goodbye for now.